been trained kind of since birth to understand the world by walking through it. That's how we make sense of the world, and that's what we want to bring to computational data, is that sense of embodiment.
Using our eyeballs is the best way for us to be able to get things into our head. I see visualization as really the primary tool for data understanding. The NREL Insight Center is a collaborative visualization space where scientists can bring their data and employ interactive graphics to be able to understand their data better.
This lab is part of the ESIF user facility. The cost of maintaining this lab is already paid for as part of that user facility, so people are able to just come in and use it.
It's the idea that you can immerse someone in a psychophysical environment so they can explore their data more naturally than they can on a laptop or desktop.
It tracks your position and it changes the camera position in the visualization based on your position. So that allows you to physically walk into the data.
Bring your data to human scale so you can walk around it, look around it, maybe even reach out and interact with it in different ways. And if you can take that data that the researcher has and encode it in a way that your brain can more easily dissect, and that's the goal here.
We've certainly had some moments when people come in and they just had never seen their data in an immersive 3D space before.
Our very first success story, and the very first thing we visualized, was the morphology of a bulk heterojunction. So this is the active layer of a solar cell. And I talked to the PI and I said, you know, your data is what I had in my mind's eye when I designed the space. Effectively shrunk him down to the nanometer level so he could kind of step inside of this morphology. He came in, he put on the glasses, he took three steps into the space, says the three most exciting words in science. Huh, that's funny. He saw something for the very first time that he'd never appreciated. We cover the entire mission space of the laboratory. So that covers things from wind to solar to biomass to battery storage to systems integration.
I see visualization as the primary way that we're going to be communicating our data in the future. So many of the analysis tools that we're using are so complicated that without visualization, we won't be able to actually know what's happening in the data.
Anybody who's doing work in the mission space, energy efficiency and renewable energy, can apply to have time in this lab.